Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we got a little bit of application questions, okay? We got a value of V, which is a classic toy car, so quite expensive in dollars. So this is the amount of dollars, okay, of a toy car, and this is like the equation for that. The T is the age of the car. So it kind of makes sense, right? Maybe the order it gets cheaper or not. Let's take a look. If the car was bought about 5 years ago, and you're supposed to graph it and estimate the value of the car 6 years from now. Okay, so let's actually do the equation first. So the value of the car is actually negative 15t plus 350. Okay, so it's a minus, so it's a depreciation. So I guess this car here, it does get cheaper the longer it gets. Okay, so I don't think it's really that classic anymore. Okay. So if I actually go ahead and draw a graph of this guy right here, at the very beginning of the year, the first year, actually when you just bought it, it's not even a year yet, okay? This is the time and this is the value of the car, right? So the very first time, the first day, the first second, when you just bought the car, it's $350, okay? So maybe somewhere here, let's put down $350, okay? However, every year you go by, the price of the car is going to drop by $15, okay? So $15, because that's $350, let's not put the $350 there. Let's actually put the $350 all the way up here, because you can only go down, you can't go up, okay? So somewhere along the time, I don't know when, you're going to go all the way depreciate until you hit the zero, okay? So, and you can't get anything less than zero. So that's basically the relationship of this graph. But we're trying to figure out that estimate the value of the car 6 years from now, okay? But remember, you didn't just bought the car. It was bought 5 years ago. So what that means is it's already been 5 years, okay? In terms of the time, it's already been 5 years. And you're trying to estimate another thing 6 years later. So what that means is by the time 6 years later, the car will be already 11 years old, okay? Does that make, kind of make sense? That means you're going to plug in 11 right into this equation right here. So you get yourself the value equals to negative 15 times 11 years plus 350. And let's figure out what that is. So you get yourself negative 165 plus $350. So this classic car that you just bought, maybe it's not that classic because you're losing money actually. It's actually just going to be $185 left over, okay? So make sure you don't buy these kind of cars because it depreciates the value. Hopefully that's a plus sign. Maybe that should be a negative sign, okay? So yeah, there you go. 11 years later, 6 years from now, but you bought it 5 years ago, remember? It's only $185 left over, okay? Thanks for watching.